sideways. Boys in the days. Sittin' sideways. Boys in the days. Sittin' sideways. Boys in the days. On a Sunday night, I might bring you some pain. Twist gang, twist squad. It's your money two times up in here. And today, this is a very special video. And this video goes out to a little person named Jasmine. Before we get to the top of this video, make sure you like this video, subscribe to my channel, and ring the bell to get notified for future notifications on this channel. Now let's get to it. This is like a story time, but also a lesson. And trust me, this should be a good one. So sit down, grab some popcorn, turn on Friday Night Smackdown, because I'm currently watching it right now. Because this story will be a good one. So, before y'all say anything about in the comments about what I'm going to tell you, yes, this story, this is also a life lesson, and I am very stupid. Like, I know the signs, I had a gut feeling, but the thing is, I should listen to my gut feeling. But my own greed and me focusing on the main priority had got me in this mess. But we'll talk about it right now. So this is a story about this girl named Jasmine. I met her on social media. First red sign. Here's why I met her. It was one day, I'm in school, we was talking about, you know, financial aid and this and whatnot. And I'm like, you know, I'm not really struggling to pay off like my tuition right now. You know, I'm paying it off, but you know, I'm just thinking I need some more. But apparently I think she was looking for somebody that was like struggling and whatnot, or a gullible fool. I don't know. It was one day, I'm in school, mind you, and I was at my class meeting. I'm in a black student union in my school, BSU. And the person texts me, Jasmine, she texted me. She said, hey, can we talk? I'm thinking, cause I check out her profile, which will be posted right here. She put on her bio that she's a BSU alumni. I'm thinking, oh, she must be an alumni from my school, because we were supposed to have an alumni night in my for BSU at Cabrini. But I'm not gonna get that to it. That's none of my business. But now she's an alumni from a different college. Or I think, I don't know. You tell me. So we've been texting for quite a lot now, but it's in a third. And she was telling me how I can make bread. Easy bread. Well, not easy bread, like not one of those little, you know, cliche scam artists be like, oh, I'm gonna get you this money, blah, blah, blah. Nah, this is an actual person. Not one of those will buy the people when not, or those actual people that make it obvious. Like, no, this is an actual person that know how to play it smart. But she's, so me and her, we've been speaking since, I would say, the second week of November to now. Well, to yesterday, because yesterday was the last time I spoke to her. She was like basically spinning on these facts, like make herself look so legit. And the thing is, I'm so stupid that I fell for this because of how she played the game. So I gave her my information, well, not all my information, just, you know, my password to my my bank account and other things, but still, all I know is she had access to my account, and she put the money in the account. Like, it didn't really fully go through. Like, here's a screenshot right there of the money, well, of the quote money that was supposed to be posted on my account, and it never popped up. Because if you can see all them pluses and minuses, the pluses mean, you know, the money has been put in. The minuses is pending, meaning that it will be added in. All right, so fast forward. I'm over here, I'm heading to AC.
apparently I was supposed to, like, you know, when I get the money processed to my account, I was supposed to take the money and go deposit to a Wells Fargo's bank. I think that's technically her bank, because the bitch already in Chicago. And, like, mind you, at this time I thought she was legit, so I'm just like, damn, I'm not gonna steal for this poor lady who's gonna help me out, why not? But you know what, if I would've knew about this and she would've still deposited that money in my account, I would've took that money. Because the bitch deserves to be having shit taken from her, because she likes to take it from other people. Alright, now let's talk about Jasmine. Well, back to talk about Jasmine. This is her picture. I don't know if she's real or not. I don't know. I actually spoke to her on the phone. This is her phone number right here. Feel free to call her, text her, call her a f***ing scam artist, because she is a f***ing scam artist. Although, yeah, I'm the one that fell for it, but still, she is a scam artist. Please, go ahead, text her, call her, do something. I don't give a f***. And, yeah. I don't care what y'all do, because her phone number will be, like, displayed for that. I actually spoke to her on the phone, and she legit, you know, she's an actual person. And for someone that's a quote business major, I'm sure people who do business majors will not scam people. And you call yourself a BSU alumni? You call yourself a Black Student Union member? An alumni, you should be ashamed of yourself. You should be ashamed of yourself. You are not a BSU alumni. No Black Student Union should claim your ass for this. I feel bad for all your fellow BSU buddies. Now I gotta sit back here and look at the fact that you was a scam artist. Me as a BSU alumni, you're supposed to help Black people, not take from Black people, not envy them, not put them down, none of that. Nah, you're supposed to help them, not take from them, you dumb bitch. Wow. Then again, as I said before, it's my own fault for being so gullible. It's my own fault. And I'm handling this very calm because joke's on her. Went to my bank because I tried to get into my account. My account was closed. And I currently got a new account as we speak. I'm not gonna disclose the rest of this information because, you know, it's really, it's too much for YouTube. But all I know is, if you're watching this, Jasmine, or if that's your real name, prepare for a case. Because they're currently tracing your account. They're tracing where the fake money was deposited at. And who's gonna get in trouble? A bitch from Chicago, from Chirac. That's what she looks like, y'all, in Chirac. So if you see this person texting you, do not answer. If she comments under your pictures and say, hey, we gotta talk, ignore the bitch. Because she's a scam artist. She's a f***ing scam artist. And honestly, I hope the worst happens to you. I hope you will never scam nobody ever again. And this is a lesson for me, and listen to anybody. If you're very desperate to pay off your college tuition, or desperate for money, try taking a loan, or work hard, work extra hours at your job, or do something. Not doing stupid shit like this. And I'm a very intelligent person, trust me. 4.0 GPA, got accepted to a very private college. But sometimes we're humans. We make mistakes, and this is my mistake right here. I want y'all to use my experience to motivate y'all to not make the same mistakes as I made. As for you, Jasmine, I'll be go choke on a dick. And this is my way of saying farewell to you. This is my farewell to you. Hopefully, I don't get demonetized of this. So, future money, please send to these. Anyhow, that's all I had to talk about today, guys. Make sure y'all like this video, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see y'all at the next video. This is your Mighty Two Times, signing out. Just play.
bump it up.